Junior, hadn't you better start on your homework?
Huh, Pop?
Junior.
Oh, Mom.
I said, hadn't you better start on your homework?
Yeah, I guess so. I'll go chop it now.
Riley.
Huh?
Put your paper down for a moment, will you, dear? I want to talk to you.
I'm listening, Peg. Go ahead.
Well, it's about Junior. I'm so worried about him. He hasn't been himself lately.
Hey, Peg, get a load of this. Rich, prominent banker, married for years, deserts wife and runs away with pretty blonde secretary, age 19. Now, why would a man want to do a thing like that?
Will you listen? You might show a little interest in your own children.
I'm interested. I heard everything you said. What about Babs? Why wasn't she home here for supper? She likes ham hocks.
Babs is over at Myrtle's rehearsing her club play. I'm talking about Junior.
Well, what about Junior?
Well, for a week now, he hasn't eaten. He just picks at his food. Did you see his plate tonight?
I can't understand.
Neither can I.
Why should an old man, married for years, run away with a pretty blonde? She must have money.
Chester Riley, if you don't pay attention...
Go ahead, go ahead.
Well, I'm trying to tell you, he just moans around the house.
Nah. What would a rich man want with money? Why would he leave his wife? Guess he likes this blonde's cooking.
I'm talking to you.
All right, go ahead.
Maybe he's sick or something. He never acted this way before. There must be some reason for it.
Well, according to this picture here in the paper of the blonde in a bathing suit, he... That's why he did it. You know, Peg, some men...
Oh, you!
What's the matter, Peg? Just because some guy runs off with a blonde, there's no reason for you to get upset.
You're the most exasperating man. Here I am, worried sick over Junior. You won't even listen to me.
Junior? Well, if it's something about Junior, come out in the open with
him. I want to know what's wrong with that boy.
Peg, I'm surprised at you. You ought to know what's wrong with him. He's in love.
In love?
Sure. Nothing serious. It's just puppy love, you know. Most likely that Marilyn Morris. Now, let me have my...
No, but it's not Marilyn. He doesn't bother with her anymore.
All right, Peg. So it's some other little girl in this class. Stop worrying. Let me...
Oh, listen, whatever it is, I want you to have a talk with him because it's affecting his schoolwork. Every day this week, he's been kept in after school.
So he's been kept in?
But he's always been so bright.
So is I. But when I was a kid, a day didn't pass by that I wasn't kept in. And that went on for years. But did it stop me from turning out to be... I better have a talk with that boy. You wait here. Hello, Sonny. I want to have a little talk with you. Junior.
Huh? What'd you say, Pop?
Pay attention to me. I want to have a little talk with you. What are you dreaming about?
Oh, nothing.
Junior, I don't want you to think of me as your father. I want you to think of me as a friend.
Huh?
You see, your mother's a little worried about you. She thinks there's something bothering you.
Oh, no, I'm okay.
You've got something on your mind.
No, I haven't. Honest.
Yes, you have, son. And I think I know what it is. Now, listen careful. There's some things that I gotta tell you. Things that you ought to know. Maybe I should have told them to you before, but... Well, anyway, I'm going to clear them up now once and for all. You see, the fact is, when a boy gets to be a certain age, he... Well, he... Let me put it another way. There comes a time in every boy's life when he... Not only you, anybody. Love is a funny thing.
Well, Pop... How can love make you feel good and at the same time awful?
Well, you know how it makes you feel.
Well, I...
I thought so. You're in love.
Oh, no.
Don't try to kid your old man, Sonny.
Yeah, I guess I am.
Well, don't worry, darling. It's nothing serious. You'll get over it.
No, I won't. I'll always love her.
Oh, wait a minute, Sonny. Take it easy. How could you know that this is real love?
I know. She's wonderful. When I look at her, I... Nah, you laugh at me.
Junior, you ought to know me better than that. Laugh at you. What kind of a father do you take me for?
Well, when I look at her, I hear bells.
Bells? You hear bells?
You said you wouldn't laugh.
I'm sorry. You're right, I apologize. But bells? Junior, you got it there. That's a sure sign when you hear bells. Who is she?
I can't tell you.
Come on, tell me. Come on, Junior, you can trust me.
I can't tell you. Please don't ask me, Pop.
Well, why not? After all, Junior, we have to share our problems. You can't hold anything back from me. If there's something troubling you, tell me what it is and I'll help you.
Well, she's older than I am.
14 and a half? 15?
No, older than that.
Junior, she's not 16.
No, 28.
28? Holy smoke, Junior, you're in love with a whole woman.
Take it easy, Bob.
Woman?
Yeah, that's one of the worst things in the world to be in love with.
Gillis, what are you doing in here? I'm busy.
I was in the kitchen to borrow the sugar, so I came looking for someone to ask permission.
All right, take the sugar. I'll see you tomorrow.
Do you think I'm the kind of a friend would walk out on you when you're in this kind of trouble with your boy?
I'm warning you, Gillis, butt out of this. That's all. This is between me and Junior.
Oh, wild horses couldn't drag an opinion out of me. But since you ain't a wild horse, I'll tell you one thing. This match between a 14-year-old boy and a 28-year-old lady just can't work out. Tell the kid.
Don't you tell me what to tell him. Sonny, this match can't work out.
I know. She's married.
Married? Who is she, Junior? Who is this cradle snatcher?
I can't tell you, Pop. Anyway, she doesn't know I love her.
I didn't borrow a whole car.
I insist that you tell me what her name is, or else I'll embarrass you. I'll go to her and I'll ask her what her name is. I mean...
I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Wait a minute, Junior, come back. Gillis, will you get out of the way?
Junior, where are you going?
Get out.
Wait a minute.
Junior.
He just ran out. What'd you say to him?
Peg, prepare yourself for a shock. Your son's in trouble.
Why, what did he do?
He's in love.
Well, what are you so excited about? A minute ago you said puppy love was nothing to worry about.
This dame's 28. That ain't puppy love. That's old dog love.
Who is she?
I don't know.
Can I borrow some sugar? A quarter cup?
Yeah, sure. Wouldn't he tell you?
No.
As a matter of fact, you owe my wife some sugar, so this makes us even. But if you want, I'll throw in the name of the dame Junior's in love with. You know? Who is she? His school teacher, Mrs. Hendrickson.
His teacher? Oh, is that who it is?
Hey, this is no joke. This is the most shocking...
Don't be silly. Sooner or later, every boy falls in love with his teacher. It's just a phase.
Well, I didn't when I was a kid, and I had more opportunity than Junior. I had the same teacher 4 years in a row.
A very stupid student. Well, I done my neighborly duty, so I'll run along. Night.
Peg, what are we going to do about this?
Do? We're just going to forget it. Now, after all,
but
the...
But, Peg, you don't understand. He's really got it bad. He tells me every time he sees that teacher, he hears bells tinkle.
Did he say that? Oh, that's cute.
Well, I don't think it's so cute. I'm going to have a talk with that teacher.
Oh, Riley, don't make a fuss.
Now, please, Peg, I know what I'm doing.
Thank you. Just a minute, lad. Is somebody ringing some kind of bell?
No, Mrs. Hendrickson.
Oh, that's strange. I distinctly hear bells.
Oh, that's just the good humor man outside.
Oh, of course, that's it. All right, class dismissed.
Excuse me.
Hello.
Excuse me, are you Mrs. Hendrickson who teaches my boy, Junior?
Junior? Oh, Chester Riley, Junior?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, yes, yes, he's in one of my other classes. Oh, he's a nice boy.
I'm his father.
Oh, I should have guessed. There's quite a resemblance.
Mrs. Hendrickson, flattery will get you nowhere. I'm here to make a complaint.
A complaint? Well, I'll be glad to discuss it with you, Mr. Riley.
Mrs. Hendrickson, my boy is in love with you.
Yes, I suspect that Junior had a crush on me. You know, I think he deliberately neglects his work in order to be kept in after school. But I wouldn't worry about these schoolboy crushes. They're really quite typical at his age. Didn't you have one on your teacher?
Me? Have a crush on my teacher? I should say not. I hated his guts.
Don't worry about your son. He'll get over it. These schoolboy crushes are really not unusual.
This ain't no crush. This is real love.
Oh, come now, Mr. Riley. At his age?
That's just it. He can't help himself. He's too young to know any better. After all, Mrs. Hendrickson, you are a very good-looking woman.
Oh, Mr. Riley.
You are. I'm a married man with two kids and a devoted husband. I mean, wife. I'm the husband. And I'm not in the habit of going around admiring other women, but you are very attractive. As a matter of fact, you're very pretty. You...
Oh,
to you and to me, like it happened to him.
I beg your pardon?
No. No. No.
Mr. Riley, are you ill? Is it your head? In here, sit down.
Don't touch me. I'm a married man.
Mr. Riley!
I
got What's on your mind, Riley? Is something worrying you, dear?
No, no, I'm okay. I feel fine.
Junior, will you please eat your supper? You haven't touched a thing.
Huh? Yeah, go ahead and eat.
I'm not hungry.
That's no excuse. Food costs money.
Well, why aren't you eating? You haven't touched a thing either. You're as bad as Junior. I don't know why I bother to cook. Oh, I wish Babs were here. Then I'd have somebody to talk to. You both sit there with a faraway look in your eyes.
We're both looking at the same thing.
What?
I don't think I want any more to eat. I think I'll take a walk around the block.
Oh, Riley.
Hiya, Riley. Your door was open,
so I just dropped in.
Yeah, how'd you know?
Gillis, I want to see you.
Yeah?
What? Well, on the job, they got a new type riveting gun. I was wondering if you could work those with the four handles on it.
Well, how's everything at school, Junior?
Huh?
Huh. That's all I get from you and your father. And I don't like it.
Go on, Riley, go on. You got a whiff of the perfume? Then you hide the bell? Then what?
I run out.
You run out? You run out?
Yeah.
You coward.
When I heard those bells, I got scared. I knew it was happening.
But it can't happen. It's happening all right. Them bells is a sure sign.
But I don't want it to happen. I love Peg. I'm gonna fight this thing.
You can't fight. You got nothing to do with it. It's beyond human control. You see, love is just chemistry.
Chemistry?
Yeah. Now, you take a man and a woman. To you, they're people. But not to the atomic scientist.
Oh,
to him, they're just a lot of protons and neutrons. Whirling around. Now, you take a couple of protons. Here, protons. Introduce them to each other. What happens?
What?
Nothing. Now, you take a couple of neutrons. What happens?
What?
Nothing. They just sit there and look at each other. But if you take a certain kind of a proton, introduce it to a certain kind of a neutron, then it happens.
What?
Boom! Hiroshima! You see? You're nothing but a great big pile of uranium. So stay away from that teacher, or boom, you'll explode. If you know what I mean.
Don't worry. I won't explode. I hardly know her. I've been married for 17 years. I love Peg.
But you hear bells when you're with the teacher. Do you hear bells when you're with Peg?
Well, sure I do.
When?
Well, when we were first married. Only, not exactly bells. It was more like fire engines.
Do you hear fire engines now when you're around Peg?
Well, not exactly.
Of course not. And I'll tell you why. Because the fire's gone out.
Well, that's what you said. But you happen to be wrong. Don't worry. I'll hear bells with Peg. She's the only girl in the world for me. I love her. I'll hear bells with her. I'll prove it to you.
Where are you going, Riley?
I'm going to make a test right now. You wait here.
I'd love a movie, Miss Van Buskirk. I'll be by for you right away. Bye. Yeah?
What? Give me a kiss, quick.
Listen. Well, what's that?
What's the matter with you?
Don't hear nothing. Give me another
Listen,
kiss.
Dear, I gotta go
Please.
To the movies.
Hey.
Well, Riley, I...
Shh.
Huh?
Nah, it's a false alarm. Give me another kiss.
I'm busy. You... me like that since we were engaged.
I don't hear anything.
I said you haven't kissed me like that since we were engaged.
Don't hear nothing.
What's wrong with your ears? I said you haven't kissed me like that since we were engaged.
Hey, will you stop shouting? I'm trying to listen.
Listen to what?
The bells.
Bells? Are you crazy?
Peg, we might as well face it.
You and me, we're just a couple of croutons.
Well, I hope you regain your sanity before I come home.
This is all your fault, Mr. Hiroshima. Oh, I've seen this thing coming for a long time. Ah, what a mess. I know that I'm in love with Peg. But why do I hear the bells when I see the teacher? I'm all mixed up. I don't know if I'm going or coming.
Make up your mind. There's a difference, believe me. I was in your garden checking up on the crocuses.
Hey, Riley, I just happened to think. If Peg ever finds out about this, you'll need an undertaker.
Serves you right for making those jokes.
Something wrong, Riley?
Well, I don't know whether I should tell you or not, Dick.
Oh, you can tell me. I won't breathe it to a living soul, if you'll pardon the expression.
I think I'm falling for another woman.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. He's got it bad, too. If that dame's husband ever finds out, you got yourself another one of them high-class $49 funerals.
That's just for this month. Holiday special. Another woman, you say?
Yeah. You're shocked. I don't blame you.
No, of course not. Who am I to be shocked at you? I, too, once cast amorous glances at a lady pallbearer. I couldn't help it. She carried me away. Tell me, Ray, does your wife know?
Gosh, no. It would be awful if Peg found out.
Then perhaps you'd better not tell her.
If she got wind of this, I'd die.
Then perhaps you had better tell her. In my profession, we have a saying. There are some things you can't cover up. Tell me, Wright, who is this mysterious femme fatale in whom you are smitten?
Mrs. Hendrickson, the teacher.
Ah, yes. Lovely, lovely.
Gee, Digger, what am I gonna do?
My advice to you is to confess all. Go to your dear spouse and confess all. Perhaps she'll forgive you.
I couldn't. I can't.
Boy, if Peg ever finds out about this, the roof will come off.
Very well, then. But don't blame me. If you get in too deep, not even I can get you out. Julia, you. I got this at an undertaker's convention. It goes down, but it won't come up.
Mrs. Hendrickson, I'm awfully glad you dropped in. Frankly, we have been a little worried about our boy.
Well, I don't think you've got anything to be worried about anymore. I'm afraid I've been jilted.
Oh?
Mm-hmm. I heard Junior asking Marilyn Morris to the class dance tonight.
Oh, really? I kept telling Mr. Riley he'd get over it.
Oh, how is Mr. Riley? Is he better?
Better? He isn't ill.
You mean he's that way all the time?
What way?
Well, I saw him yesterday and... Oh, it's nothing. I really have to be running along, Mrs. Riley. I'm meeting my husband downtown.
Oh, won't you stay and have some tea?
Oh, well, please don't bother.
Don't bother. I was making it anyway. Excuse me. I'll be back in a jiffy.
Gee, Peg, you look... Whoa! Mrs. Hendrickson.
Oh, well, good evening, Mr. Riley.
Good evening. Is my wife here, teacher? I mean, Mrs. Hendrickson?
Yes, she's in the kitchen.
That's nice. Hey, something's wrong. I'm in a room with you and I don't hear anything.
I said she's in the kitchen.
I don't hear nothing.
I said she's in the kitchen.
I don't hear nothing. You know what that means.
You should see a doctor.
No, I don't love you. Isn't that wonderful?
Yes. Yes, it is.
Here's the tea. Hello, Riley.
I don't think I can stay to tea. I just remembered I have an appointment, some test papers. Excuse me. Good night.
My, she's acting awful strange.
What did you say to her?
I told her I didn't love her.
You what? Honestly, sometimes I think I married a raving lunatic.
No. Hey, I love you. I've always loved you. Can't you hear the bells?
Yes, I can hear them.
Peg, you can? Gee, you know what that means.
Yes, it means there's a good humor man outside. You want chocolate or vanilla?
Humor man? But I thought... Then I've been in love with you all the time.
Well, I should hope so.
What a revolting development this is.
Charlie, of all the crazy ideas.
I mean, okay, Peg, I made a mistake. Everybody makes mistakes. You mad at me, Dumplin'?
Oh, why should I be mad?
Give me a little kiss. Wonder where the fire is. Can't you hear the fire engines?
I don't hear any.
Sure. They must be right outside. That's funny. They're not out there.
Of course not.
But I heard them so close.
Well, I didn't hear anything.
You mean you didn't hear all the bells? Oh? Oh? Was that Gillis wrong?
What about?
Hey, the fire's still going strong, even though the stove is pot-bellied.
What?
I love you, baby.
Well, naturally.